transition from female to male, it was kind of a quiet transition for me. I had talked to the principal, you know, I had talked to teachers of mine. So I was one of the first kids to transition in high school at Desert Vista. So everyone was kind of trying to figure it out. I met my first trans person when I was in seventh grade, and that automatically clicked for me. In my junior year of high school, I came out as trans and then went through the motions of transitioning.
Generations of fathers and sons, misunderstood. Always seeking one another's forgiveness. Always seeking love. I couldn't hear my father in Rochester, the city where he was born. I couldn't see him, but I felt him. And I longed to embrace him in this place he called home. I used to hate the way my father sounded when he sang. But now, I would give anything to hear his voice again.
Scientific processes are often difficult for us to understand as laymen.
We were playing, it was the sixth, seventh game of the year, my senior year in 1968, playing University of New Mexico. New Mexico did not have a very good team. By halftime, we were losing 28-7. So we go in at halftime and, he's very upset with us. But we came out in the second half and we ended up scoring 57 additional points. And I'll tell you what I took from that, and that is simply your mental engagement, your mental focus.
I'm proud. I'm proud of the fact that I lasted. I certainly was not a first teamer, but I stuck it out. Coach Kush did put ASU on the map, and appropriately.
50 years has passed, and when you look back on it, I realize it's not yesterday, but it always seems like yesterday.
And to this day, a lot of those guys are still very, very close to me and will always be. Herman Cernies, he's my son's godfather. And when you choose someone to be your son's godfather or your daughter's godfather, you want to make sure that that person espouses to your child the same kind of things that you would espouse to him. Couldn't find anybody better than Herman to do that. Arizona State has significance now. It has prominence. My degree is worth more in my mind today than it was 50 years ago.
We try to work in locations that are the most urgent. So in other words, where the most sea turtles are being entangled and killed in gill nets and in other types of fisheries. Right now, we're seeing about a 65 to 70% reduction in sea turtle bycatch through the technologies that we developed. And I'm really excited to see how we take that 65% and make it 95 or 100%.
I think they teach it at the Cronkite School now, of course, the free press. Eye is so important, and you look at other countries where journalism is an arm of the state. It's so important that we have a free, independent press.
Students should not be afraid to tell the truth and to spread the truth. Students should go after ambitious stories. That's very important to all newspapers, including the state press. They shouldn't be afraid to tackle complicated issues. They should trust their training to be able to deliver those stories in a fair and balanced and accurate way. Being able to have that voice is important for the campus, it's important for the students, and they should absolutely use it.
The pandemic stopped all artists in their tracks. All of our planning ahead, all of our detail-oriented, excruciating note-taking and planning and systems and structures and auditions and calendaring and budgeting, it all just disappeared.
And so while we look at other schools that come into the region to be themselves, just with a new office, we're looking at coming into the region and being a bit more humble and a bit more open to shifting and flexing and adapting to what this region needs, and make sure what we're doing is Thunderbird, but is also appropriate and important for this space in the world.
We think we've got an opportunity here, both with Thunderbird and more broadly, to build America's greatest 21st century public university.
It's not a goodbye. It really is to give honor to a place that laid the foundation for so many opportunities for individuals, but not as a place, but as a point of congregation for the people. And it is people that believe that the story of Thunderbird is bigger than Glendale, Arizona.
Ta-da.